Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Maori, and thank you for joining me today. I got something very, very, very important to share with you. During this time, during the COVID-19 epidemic, a lot of people are in disarray. They're going through depression, they have anxiety issues, they don't know when the next paycheck is going to come in or if they're ever going to get a job. And one of the things we miss most is sports. And if you're kind of like me, grew up here in Dallas, Fort Worth, you're a big fan of the Rangers, the Dallas Mavericks with Luka playing lights out. But are any of them Mexican-American? Are any of those players Mexican-American? Do any of them look like me or look like you? You know, wouldn't it be great if we were able to support someone that grew up in our neighborhood? Well, let me tell you about a story of a young boy who started out getting introduced to the world of boxing at 5 years old by his father, Virgil Ortiz Sr. This little boy named Virgil Ortiz Jr. was only 5 years old, and he had a dream to become a superstar boxing sensation. He started working out in Oak Cliff in a little bitty old gym. He managed to be a 7-time national champion and winner at the 2013 Junior Olympics. He continued his education and graduated in Grand Prairie High School, the same high school his father went to. There was some hardships and there was a lot of hard times.
Also, I want to thank my dad for getting me this position, because, you know, without my dad, I really wouldn't be here. You know, he didn't have the best childhood growing up, and he made sure that he did everything in his power to, you know, I don't think his dad was there for him when he grew up, and he made sure that he was there for me. Even though my mom wasn't there, he played both parts. That's something you don't see all the time. Usually it's the mom that stays with the kid. My dad, he stayed with me throughout the entire way. He supported me the entire time. And yeah, thank you, Dad, I love you.
The number one promotional company, Golden Boy Promotions, signed him in 2016. This guy started kicking ass. I'm talking about putazos after putazos. Se estaba chingando a todos.
Letting the punches fly.
Power.
Wicked attack from Ortiz.
But his father was always there. He also had my boy Hector Beltran helping him out as well. And he hooked up with Ring Magazine Trainer of the Year, Robert Garcia. He left everything and took all his dreams to Cali and started training with Robert Garcia. This young man was sparring with the best of the best. With all that hard work and determination, you can see the discipline. You can see how relentless this young man is. He is a knockout machine. Right now, he is 15-0. And out of those 15 fights that he's won, they've all been knockouts.
Boy, if you a baller, then you know me. Girl, if you a stunner, then you know me.
I know you know me.
Living the life of a young OG.
Yeah.
And everybody doing that.
Mr. Wolf, connected
ENT.
Boy, if you a baller,
then you know me.
Girl, if
you a stunner, then you know me.
I know you know me.
Living
the
life of a young OG.
If you ain't heard, you need to know by now.
This guy is so good Golden Boy Promotions had him on all the Canelo fights on the undercard. You're probably like, who is this guy? You know? I'm ready for the Canelo fight. I'm here to tell you, everybody is talking about him.
Virgil Ortiz is the real deal, and everybody knows it. I challenge through Virgil, of course. Sorry, Virgil, but I'm your promoter, so I gotta hype you up. Virgil will beat anybody. At 147, he will destroy anybody.
It makes me proud to know that one of ours, from right here in the Metroplex, is now being advertised as the future of boxing. DAZN has an ad out right now promoting him as the future of boxing.
The future of boxing is coming at you fast.
And this fight is over! The homecoming, a rousing success!
And his name is Virgil Ortiz Jr.
Herrera's out!
Last year in 2019, Ring Magazine named him Prospect of the Year. If that doesn't tell you something, I don't know what does. I interviewed him a couple of months ago. I was like, man, what clubs you be hitting up now? Man, I just be at the crib playing my guitar and piano. This is what this guy does in his off time. I asked him about girlfriends. Ain't got time for that. Y le está echando chingazos. This guy does not stop. And now there's a fight coming up this Friday, the 24th of July, and all eyes are on Virgil Ortiz. I do have to add one very important thing. Virgil Ortiz and his father, they're not haters at all. They're gonna support their people. So they went to Golden Boy and said, listen, I don't know if you know this or not, but there's a kid from Oak Cliff named Hector Valdez, who is a pretty good prospect. You might wanna look at him. What happened? Hector Valdez from Oak Cliff went to Adamson High School, my alumni, right? Alumni from there. He got signed to Golden Boy. He is going to be fighting in the undercard this Friday. So you got two guys from Dallas that are going to be representing Friday. And it's going to be on and popping, baby. So do me a favor. Let's support our people, especially if that money is coming back to us. You know, we hear about all of the black people getting together, supporting black-owned businesses. And, you know, so before you buy the $150 cowboy jersey, why don't you buy a Virgil Ortiz shirt that's about $20-25, you know? Support Virgil Ortiz, Hector Valdez. They're representing right here. Y son raza. Pura pinche raza. And they're coming here from Dallas-Fort Worth. Ya saben todos ustedes that Virgil Ortiz is right here from our backyard. This guy is the future of boxing. Jump in the bandwagon right now. Share this video. Watch a fight Friday and support your boy.
Wearing black with gold this evening and representing Dallas, Texas. Dallas, Texas. Dallas, Texas. Dallas, Texas. Dallas, Texas. Ladies and gentlemen, Virgil Ortiz Jr.
Says, I wasn't punished, but big right hand to the top of the head, and down goes Evandro Caballero.
Catch me in the D, posted big T, eating Rudy